Right. So the class, or say the course, what we're actually learning is Tableau. Now, many people have this doubt that what is this Tableau, or say what is this, you know, tool, or whether I should use this Power BI or any other business intelligence tools. See, there are many business intelligence tools in the industry. In that, Tableau and Power BI actually plays a very major role. But why actually we have to choose these tools? Why the companies are actually going, you know, more usage of these kind of softwares? So first we have to understand that. Then we'll also understand what actually it is, why it is actually used in the industry. Many companies are actually going behind these business intelligence tools. So first of all, let's understand what is this business intelligence itself. Okay. So to understand, business intelligence is nothing but I have a raw data. How will I actually show that in a more better presentable way? Right. So I have a raw data completely, which is taken from different sources. How will I show that in a more presentable way? Now, when I say presentable way, what all things should be there? Either it can be visualizations, or it can be in a very formatted way. It can be in a table way, or it can be in some, say indicators, or in some, say scorecards will have some indicators, or say I have some tables where I'll show the data, or I'll show it as a visualizations, which can be like charts or graphs or many other things. So I get a raw data that has to be presented in a very, you know, beautiful way. For that, I'll use all these technologies which will help me in showing it in a very neat, presentable manner. So for that, we have various tools. Those various tools are nothing but these business intelligence tools. When it comes to business intelligence tools, these business intelligence tools will not have its own database. What they actually do is they'll depend on the data sources from various other sectors. When I say business intelligence tools, these will concentrate more on visualizations. So when I say visualization, it can be a table, or it can be charts or graphs, or I was talking about indicators. So likewise, they actually differ with visualizations. But what I'm telling is the data will be converted into more presentable way. So for that reason, I'll be using this business intelligence tools. Now, the current trend is there are so many business intelligence tools. Mainly Tableau, Power BI, MicroStrategy, then we have ClickView, we have Zoom. There are so many, you know, business intelligence tools which actually help us in creating the reports. So now what you're learning, Tableau is one of the business intelligence tools which is very much simple, easy, and very much elegant in presenting your visualizations. Many people actually assume that Tableau is very difficult, or, you know, it's very difficult for me to work on that or create reports. So many things that they'll have the confusions. But I'll tell you, first, what you should do is understand the concept of pivot tables. Just think you know how to create pivot tables, then most of your concepts in Tableau is easily understood, because the concept of pivot tables is what used in my business intelligence. Most of the business intelligence tools use the concept of pivot tables. When I say pivot tables, what actually we do, we'll just drag and drop few things. Say I'll drag one column in row headers, I'll drag one column and put it in column headers, or say in values. Same thing we are doing in my business intelligence tools as well. But when it comes to Tableau, it is more simpler, because it is very much similar to your Excel concepts. In Excel, we have formulas. In Tableau also, we have formulas. In Excel, we have charts. Here also, we have charts. In Excel, we have pivot tables. Here also, you have the concept of pivot tables. But it is still easier than Excel, because in Excel, suppose if you want to create a complex charts, I have to align the data. But in Tableau, it is not like that. Everything is inbuilt. You just have to drag and drop and you will get the results. Then what actually I should learn? Here, I should be learning more of options, how I can use these options to create more elegant, say, reports. Okay, fine. Now, I open my Tableau here. I've installed my Tableau. Now, what will happen is, this Tableau, the software, it is actually chargeable, or say it is a paid software. But most of them have got doubt. Say I want to practice, I cannot invest so much. So what they can do is there are different version of Tableau what we can download. First thing is, if you can see here, see this is the latest version what you have, say 2020.1.2. This is the latest version. Now suppose if you want to install this, you can just go to the website of Tableau. There you'll get the downloads. Let me just check if I can open that. Say Tableau software download, and I'll go to this official site. This is a free trial. I'll show you. Now if you go here, click here, it'll ask for some details. You can enter all these details, and then after that you can download it. This is for the free trial version. But after that, when you're installing it, this is a desktop version I'm telling. Once you install, it will give me 14 days the trial period. So after that, you have to register. Then how will I get registered? Suppose I don't do, I'm not actually doing any commercial projects. I'm not working on any projects wherein I'm doing any business. But I want to learn. How will I get the full version? How will I get a version which can be extended? See, one is we have a free student version for 1 year. How to get the student version? So what will happen is when I install this software, if I have any students, you can just take the ID front and the back of the ID card of the students who are still studying. You can just post it and you will get the say product code wherein you can use it. It will be a complete version for 1 year. So you can use that for 1 year. But this, if you feel that I don't have any students where I'm not able to get the ID, then what you can do is there is a free version, a complete free version of your Tableau, but that is called as public. The Tableau public version, what you have, you will get a complete say a Tableau version. But here only problem is I can work on everything, but I cannot save the data in my desktop. Okay, understand. If I have this Tableau desktop, that means I can work on the files, then I can save it in my desktop. Also, I can publish it. But when it comes to Tableau public, it is completely free with full version. Only thing is, I cannot save my file in my desktop. The complete data is stored in the cloud, that is in Tableau server. In this case, you should not keep any of your critical data, that is very confidential data, because it will not be such secured. But for practicing or for any other, say some simple dashboards if you want to create, you can use this public. Then we have something called as Tableau server, which will be very much similar to your desktop version, but everything, whatever you're doing, that can be shared in my server. And from that server, many of them from different places can access it. Okay, then we have Tableau Reader, wherein this Tableau Reader is just to read only the say visualizations. You cannot work, you cannot create reports, or you cannot modify anything. You can just view. It is for those who just view the reports. But again, I'll repeat, you have Tableau Desktop, which you can use very flexibly installing in your system. But for that, one is paid version, other one is you can take student version for practicing. If you want a student version, then you'll have to submit a student ID card, and then you'll get a product ID which you can install, and this will be for 1 year. The next is Tableau Public, which is completely free, wherein the data will be stored in the public, or say in the server. And Tableau Server, this server is actually completely, again, this is also paid version, but this one will give me a lot of cloud space where I can store all the data in my server space. And then we have Tableau Reader, which will actually help me in just viewing. So for this, I don't have to worry about anything. So it is just to read the visualizations, whatever is here, that is to view, that's all. So, okay, these are the different versions what we have. So you see which one you can use it for installing the softwares. Okay, fine. Next is how to use these Tableau software. Now what we'll do is, see, once I open this Tableau, we have different versions. The latest version what you see is this one. Say 2020.1.2 is the latest version, and you don't have to worry about the versions. Why? Because as and when there are some updates, it will be keep on getting updated. So you don't have to bother about whether I need to purchasing the new versions or anything. It's not like that. It is like it will keep on updating your software and new features will be getting added. But for time being, you can install Tableau public and practice. That is more than enough. Why I'm telling is, anyways, in the beginning itself, you're not working on any critical data or say confidential data. So what you do is download Tableau public. It is a very small file, around some 150 MB or 200 MB, within that range. You can just download it and you can install it and start working on it. Okay, fine. Now, once I open this Tableau, what all things are available? What all things I should actually know before start creating visualizations? This is very important. Don't straight away jump for visualizations. Always try to understand the background of it. Always understand the options and then think about start working on say simple reports, semi-complex, and then complex and advanced, like that. Let me talk about the layouts of this. Once you go here and see, I have a complete layout here, which has been divided into one, this part, and the other one is this part. And here I can see one more, this part. So what are this? Let me just explain all this. If you see here, I have something called as connect. And here it says open. And here it says discover. This one is for complete database. That is to connect to another source where I get the data and then start creating the reports. This space, what you see, this is very similar to your Excel or MS Office application where I have recently opened file. Can you see this here? Suppose if I have opened something here, so it will just show me what are the recent opened files. The one what you see here, this is the very useful tab. What you can see, this is called as a discover, where you have so many options here, wherein you'll be getting some videos of the trainings of the complete Tableau. But here only thing is, they'll give some basic information so you can understand what it is. So you have more videos here. For this you have to register. Once you register, then you'll get all the videos. You can view the videos as well here. Then we'll be having some blogs here, wherein many people actually, if they have any doubts, they'll be keep publishing it, and then you can go and you can check that. Suppose if you have any doubts, you can go and you can post it there. So there'll be so many people, so many members who can answer your queries as well. So this part, what you see, this is something useful for the learners or to have some doubts with professionals as well. And here below you have these versions. So any point of time, if any version, say it has been updated, here you'll get one icon like this, a button like this. If you click on this, a new version will be downloaded. You can start, working on it. Okay, fine. Next, let's come back to this. So what you see here, this is called as connector. See, it's very easy to remember and say connect. That means I'm trying to import or connect to the data. So I cannot say import because I cannot save the data here. So it says connect. So what it will do, it will go and connect to any of the sources, and then the data what I have, that data will be pulled and I can create the visualizations. Let's say how. See, when I say connect, there are two ways the data is connected. One is file, other one is server. So what is file and what is server? Why there are two different types? See, when I say file, all the flat files, all the files which I'll be saving in my desktop or in my system or in my server that can be accessed here. So what are different type of files, structure we have? Say MS Excel. Suppose if I have data in my MS Excel, I can connect it. Suppose if it is with the TXT files or the CSV files, I can connect. Suppose if I have MS Access, how will I connect with MS Access? I can connect it here. So all the files or the data which is there in file types, I can connect it from these options. But coming to this, this is for the huge or bigger projects, bigger data, what we actually save somewhere in the server. If you want to get the data, then I'll be using this server. So what is this server? See, I have MS SQL server. When I say SQL server, it can hold a very big, data. So it can have huge data in that. If you want to connect, then I can use this server and I can connect to server and I can pull the data. I have this MySQL, it's again a server where I can get the data. Oracle, Amazon. Suppose if I'm using something more than these servers, there are so many different servers now. So many are there. If you want to connect, then I'll click on this more. Just click on this. You can find almost all the database servers globally. See? I am not completely aware of most of them, but a few of them I know. Let's say MongoDB. Here you have this Mongo, see? Oracle. You have SAP HANA. All these SAP products are here. Okay, so we have Dropbox. Then we have Google Analytics as well, see? Google Data, so Google Sheets. So all these are actually servers. You can get connected with these servers and then you can start creating the reports. Okay, so here I have this files, I have these servers which help me in connecting to that particular data and then start creating the reports. So this is very important for you guys. This is very important because, as I told you, the business intelligence tools itself will not have its own database. It will connect to the external database and then it will pull the data from there and then it will create the reports. Let's take one example. Let's go with Excel. Let me click on this Excel sheet. I'll see if I have some data. I'll just try to connect it. I'm just clicking on this. So it is trying to connect. So you should have patience while working on business intelligence tool because they are not so very fast like what we think. Let me go here. I'll see if I have some data here quickly. Okay, let's say I'm taking one file here. And I'll say, okay. Once I say, okay, what will happen? It'll connect. So again, I'm telling you guys, if you're working on business intelligence tool, please have patience because it is little slow. See, there are a few database in that Excel sheet. If you want, I'll open that Excel sheet also so that you can see the data, what is there in that. Let me just see data for joins. This is the file which I used. I'll open this file. I'm trying to open that file which I connected. See, I have the data here, set data, segment, ship mode, customer, location, product. Let's go to this Tableau and see data, customer, location, product, segment, ship mode, same data I have here as well. So the data what I have here has been connected here, which will help me in creating the reports. I'll come to this data part. This is just the connection part what I'm actually explaining you. So let's not jump the topics. Let me go back. Now I want to go back to that screen. Now I got this data. I'm coming out of that welcome screen. So where is that? How to go to that? So you don't have to bother. See, I'm not able to see it. So don't bother. Here, I have a button here. Can you see this? This is the Tableau icon here. So it is called as start page. It will take me to the start page or welcome page. You can also use the shortcut key, that is Control 2, which will take me to that particular page. Let me click on this. See, I'll just click on this. Again, I'll go back here. See? Fine. Now, let me go back to that data source. Again, if you click on that, I can see I have this icon. Click on this. Again, I'll go to this data source. Now, if I connect again, if I connect one more data, it'll get added here. I don't want that. So what I'll do, I'll just try to close this. Don't worry. This is a separate chapter. I'll explain. I'm just trying to close this. Closed. Let's come to this text file. Let's see if I can take some text file. You can import some text file. Let me check if I have any text files here. I'm just trying to check if I have some text files. See, tools, text columns. Okay. Let me take this data. Just random data I'm taking. Okay. Just to show you how to connect. So I'm just trying to show you the connection. I'm not talking about the data now. Let me say open. See, this is a text file. Once I say text file, see, the data is imported here. Let's go to the data and check how it looks. Here I'll say MS Excel. Then I'll go here, say data tools. This is what I took. So this is the data what I took. Let me open that. See, this is how the data will be. You know that CSV files are, the data files will be something like this, very jumbled, right? Now I took this data and I imported it, and then I can start creating the reports out of it. This is how we'll be connecting. Let me just close this as well. Fine. We learned about connecting this file. Now I'm not able to show this server because I don't have this server connection. But if you want to have the server connection, just click on this. I'll just show you how it will be. When I click on this, it lasts for the connection. I don't have the server connection. I'm sorry. So if you have the server connection, you have to just mention the server here. It will automatically specify if you have the server, and then say you have to authenticate it by signing in because the server is very secured. Once you give this authentication, it will just directly connect. And once the data comes in your say Tableau, you will get the same data like what we had in when we connected this Excel. So you'll get the data in the similar manner. Okay. So this is actually for the data connection. Fine. The next one, what we have is here, we have saved data sources. The saved data sources, what you have, this is what is a sample data, which has been given by Tableau. And this data, what you see, say supermarket or say the superstore or say EU superstore, world indicators, all these three are actually the default data which has been given by Tableau itself for practicing, learning and becoming experts in Tableau. If you go to any Tableau websites, if you go to any of the Tableau blogs, most of the examples will be from these database only, and these database will be keep getting updated as and when the versions also get updated. But where are these available? See, I just have to go and click. I don't have to import. See, if you want to import a new custom data, that is my own data, then I have to go to this file and say server. Suppose I want to learn, I don't have data. What I can do is I can just directly go and click any of these and start learning. What I will be doing for teaching you guys, I'll be using this sample superstore, which is having all kind of data, which will help me in learning easily. And I'll be teaching you almost all the visualizations available, along with that more advanced way of making your visualizations as well. Okay, fine. Let me just click on this and I'll show you how it actually looks. See, when I click on this, see, I will get the data imported here. Let's go to this data source. Similarly, when I imported data with Excel, can you see that I imported? So I got the data here. Similarly, an Excel file has been imported here. So where this will be available, I'll show you. If you go to this C drive and say program files, here I'll have this Tableau. See, I'll go to that folder. Then here I'll have this somewhere I'll have that data here, say data source, and here I'll have the sample source. See, If you open this, just opening the data, see, it's the same data what you have seen, orders, people, and return. And again, don't bother. So every software, every person who is installing this Tableau will get this data. So you don't have to bother whether I'm receiving this data or you have to upload it or I have to copy it from somewhere. Don't worry. This data is available as soon as you install Tableau software. Okay, fine. So once I import, say once I connect the data, what will happen is I'll come to a place called as data source. See here, I connected the data. I'm telling you again, so you can connect your custom data from these two places, that is file and server. For the training purpose, what I did is I'm using this Superstore, which is very much similar to your importing the data from any of these sources. So I just clicked on Superstore, then I came to this data source. This data source is the place where all your data which is connected will be displayed. Okay, fine. Now once I connect the data, see here, the table name is here, sample Superstore. It will also show me what application it has been imported. Here it says MS Excel. If I import it from CSV files or text file, it will show me here as text file. If I'm importing from MS Access, it will show me that application. If I'm importing from server, it will show me that server name here, so that it will be easy for any the business intelligence say analyst to know from where I'm actually getting the data. Okay, fine. Next, after this, if you go here and check, see, I have the tables, orders, people, returns, which you saw in this Excel file. Can you see this? Orders, people, returns. So that will be available here as well. See, order, people, returns. These are the tables which you have imported. Now, if I want to work on this data, if you want to work on the reports, first thing what I have to do is I have to make sure that the data has been taken to this workspace. This is a data space what you have here. In this space, I need to take the data. By default, what will happen? One table will be available here. If it is not there, you have to not bother. You have to just drag and drop here. I'll show you. If these data are not there here in this data space, I cannot create the reports. Can you see that? I don't have any columns, any data. It is not available. Let me go back to this data source. I want the reports to be created. So what I'll do here, I'll take one table, drag it and drop it here. See, you just have to drag. See, I'll show you. Just drag and drop. Can you see that? Finish. Now the data is available here. You should have the data here, at least one table. Otherwise, you will not be able to create the reports. Now let me go to this sheet and check. See, I have the data again. Let me just show you again. I'll say remove. Now I'll go to this sheet. I don't have anything. Let me go back. I'll take this orders and I'll pull it here. See, I'll get that. Let me remove these orders and take another table. See, I'll take this people and I'll put it here. See, I have this data only this much. Let me go here. See, I have only that data here. So whatever table you're dragging and dropping, only that data will be available here. Let me remove this. Now people will have doubt whether only one table can be taken at once. See, you can have multiple tables here. Let me drag this and I'll drop it here. This is one table. Now I'll take this table and I'll drop it here. This is another table. Forget about these things. I'll explain this in a next chapter. You can take any number of table and keep dragging and dropping here, provided all the tables what you're dragging and dropping should be linked. Then only I'll get a proper results. Otherwise, you will end up with wrong results. Okay, so what I'm trying to tell you guys is the reports can be created either with only one table or multiple tables as well. But when I'm actually taking these tables into this area, make sure that every tables are connected properly. How they are connected, how to check this connection, that itself is a separate chapter which is called as joins and blending. Once you come to that chapter, I'll explain the complete detail about how to work on multiple tables. Until then, we'll not concentrate on this. We'll just forget for time being and work only on one table, so that first we'll learn how to use data, how to create visualizations from data, and then after that we'll see how we can use multiple tables. So that is how, if you learn, it will become more easy and more understandable. This is for multiple tables. Now coming to another concept, here I have this sample superstore. It says Microsoft Excel. What will happen when a data is coming from different sources? I cannot always expect the data will be in only one single file and I'll be getting in one shot and I'll start creating the reports. You know that the data will be coming from different sources, different places, from different clients. In that case, what will happen? Say client one is sending me the details about the production. Client two is sending some other product details. Client three is sending about the financial reports. Now I have to connect all these three from different sources they are giving. The client one is sending me in Excel. Client two is sending me in CSV file. Client three is sending in SQL Server. Now what to do? One way is, previously what we used to do, convert all this into one source. Let's say convert all this into Excel and then import it and then create the reports. But here the concept is totally different. As I told you, the business intelligence tools, or in Excel we have power pivots. If any of you would have worked on that, power pivots, they actually give me the concept of importing data from different sources. Now let's take a simple example. I have this Microsoft Excel. Now what I'll do, I'll try to just import a data from text file just to show you guys. I'll say add. Now I'll say text file. So now I have Excel file. I'll say text file. Let me just take one text file, these two tables. So don't worry about the data. I'm just trying to show you the connection. See, I got the text files as well here. As I told you, see, the connection is not proper. It is giving me warning and there is no data. So forget about this part. Just understand. Can you see this? It says text file and here it says Microsoft Excel. So you can have cross data source connection. Okay, so you don't have to think that always the data, if I'm working on Excel, the complete data should be in Excel. Nothing like that. You can have data from Excel, CSV files, or any other sources, and then connect it and then start creating the reports. Until it is outside, say as a data source, it will be in different applications. Once it is coming inside, only the names will be mentioned here, but the data what I'll be working, it will be in a similar manner. Just because it is from text file, it will have a different format, or say in Excel, it will have a different format. Nothing like that. Once it is imported to my Tableau, all the data will be similar. Okay, fine. Let me just remove this. And I'll go and check this data. So we'll remove this connection as well. I have only this superstore. So we learned about how to connect, how to drag and drop different tables in this workspace. Then we saw how to connect different data source itself. Then we saw about how we get the columns here once we drag and drop the data here. And we learned various different connections here. Okay, so I'll just give some 5 minutes. You just unmute and ask me if you have doubts, and then I'll go to next part Again, we'll discuss more on this data part. Okay, so I'll just unmute, or if you guys want to speak to me, just unmute and then you can ask me any doubts if you have.
Hello.
Yes. Address me your name so that
Hello.
I'll know who is speaking.
Srinivas.
Yes, Srinivas.
So this is Srinivas.
Yes, Srinivas.
So what if I have to club Microsoft Word, which is in text format, with the Excel?
Okay. See.
Oh, what if should I have to send text file?
No, no. Wait. So you have data in Microsoft Word, correct? Sandeep.
Correct. Yes, sir.
Sandeep, am
yes,
I
sir, correct?
Okay. So your question is, I have data in Microsoft Word. How will I connect it to Tableau? Correct?
Yes, sir. Both in Excel. I have to club it.
See, I'll tell you what. Word is not supported in my Tableau because Word is not a database. It's a document. Okay. If at all I have a data in Word, what you have to do is you have to move that to either Excel or CSV or the text file, and then you can connect it to Tableau. Directly, you cannot connect it from Word here because Word is not a database. It's a document software, a documentation application. Got it?
So then you have PDF file over there.
See, PDF again.
Even it is a document application.
I'll tell you what. See, PDF again, not all the PDFs can be imported. It should be in a format of a database. And this PDF is for the newer versions. Okay. You cannot have, so in the previous versions, you don't have this PDF, this thing. So the Word, whatever is there, if that has got table format, see what will happen, I'll tell you. Technically, there are something called as tags. Okay, the tags should be of a table format. Then only I can actually take. Otherwise, it is not possible. Just as a normal PDF also, I cannot take here. It should be with a proper table format. The better way is move it to the Excel file or CSV files. It will be more, you know, easy for you to work on the reports.
So, okay, so thank you.
Yeah, okay. Any other doubts? Feel free, guys. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi. Adi Anil this side. Right. So I just wanted to ask, it's like so it's like even in the Excel file, it's like we can use any kind of Excel file, is the data should be in a proper format, like a Tableau driven format, or it's like,
okay, so it's a very good question, which I actually wanted to discuss when it comes to the data part, but still you asked, I'll just brief you, then I'll explain about how the data should be. See, people, the data should be a very clean formatted way. Okay, so there is something called as data, say Tableau prep, which will help me in cleaning the data. But again, that's a different level of working on Tableau reports. But when you're actually trying to import, the data should be in a proper format, and it should be in this format, say from A1 like this, so that it's a proper table and it can be imported properly. Suppose if you're inserting somewhere here, you know, you might get some space here, or you might get some different way of importing data, which will not give you a proper results. So it is very good practice, and what I say is it's compulsory that you have the data starting from here only, which is a cleaned format. Anil, did I answer your question? Anyways, I'll be explaining in detail in the next.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Any other?
I was thinking it's like same actually. So it was like that we need to convert everything into the rows to column or something, so that every row, every data come in just after the
Don't
another.
Be.
It's like that, or just
next.
I just
sure. So anyways, I wanted to explain. Now what we learned was only to connect. So next whatever we are
next
on data, so that we'll understand more on this data. Any other doubts?
Makes sense, Adi. Yeah.
Sure.
No, it's fine.
Any other doubts, people? Others?
Hi, Adi. Sandeep here.
Sandeep, tell me.
What if there are blanks in the data? Let's say, see, my Excel file is correct, let's say it started from here and somewhere I have the data, but there were few blanks in between.
Let's say
so do I have to verify while importing, or
so you're telling that I have blank something like this, right?
Yes, yeah.
So what will happen is these things will be considered as null. This will be considered as null.
Okay, I still get the visualization.
Pardon?
I'll still be getting the visualization based on the blanks, is it?
Yes. So this will see when I go here, if I don't have any value, say for example, I have some data here. Now I have blank here. Let's take example like this. See, I have a blank here like this. That means I don't have data. Let's say I have this as the ship mode 3. When I'm actually trying to have visualization, it'll take, when I create a pivot table, what will happen? It'll take the unique value and it'll add this one. How will it know that, this is a blank, right? This is nothing. If it was like this, say like this, right? Now, when I take this as a report, if I'm taking count, I'll get count for this. If I'm taking sum of this, then I'll get only this. So this will be zero or say null, like that.
Yeah, okay. So
data will be imported. It's not that it will not be imported, but whatever data I have, only that will be considered.
Okay, right.
Any others?
Okay.
Doubts? Till now, whatever we have done. I told you guys, this is, let's keep it very open. So, nothing much of technical things I'm telling. Why I'm telling is, guys, see, a few of them asked doubt whether it should be in a proper format or it should be a blank. So, all these actually sounds, it might sound very silly, but I'm telling you, these play a very important role. If your data is not properly aligned, then you might get wrong result. Someone asked whether what will happen if it's a blank. See, that's also a very good doubt, because if you're not able to understand this, if you are having something like this, what will happen to the result? So all this you should know. That is, study of data is very important when you come to these reports. It's very, very important actually. Okay.
Hello.
Any other doubts? Yeah.
Sir, if I modify the data, will the visualization change
back? Very good question. So I'll explain in the next session. In the next topic I'll explain that. It's a good question. I have that discussion here. I'll do that. Okay, shall we proceed? We have more interesting things to learn. So though it is not a practical thing today, but I'll have to you'll get to know more informations next listening. Okay. Fine. So I'll just continue. Then again, I'll give you some more time. Then we can discuss. Okay. Fine. Now, we're talking about the data. We just imported some data here. So what will happen is, when I say import, the importing will happen. It's not import, it's connecting. When I connect the word, what will happen is it'll go and connect to the source. Source in the sense, say I have this Excel sheet, I've connected to this Excel sheet. Now, coming back to this, when I'm connecting, can you see this here? Connection, it says live and say extract. Here I have two options. One is live and one is extract. This live connection means it is connecting directly to the source. Whatever data I have in the source, that will be connected here. That is live. Whatever data is there, that will be available here. If I change the source data, and if I'm using this live, so what will happen here? This will have the modified data. That means if I go and change the source, here also I will get updated. Okay. See here, if I say refresh, can you see this? Refresh. If I click on this refresh, whatever data is there, whatever data is updated, that will get refreshed here. That means it is live. Understood? Live means whatever data I have connected, if I'm changing the source, it will get updated here as well. Then what is extract? Let me click on this extract. Extract is actually a kind of option. Suppose I'm not able to connect to the live data. This usually we use this for the servers. I'm in office. I'm working on some data. I'm working on some visualizations. So I have to go on a vacation or say I'm taking a leave, or for some reason I'm not getting connected to the live data. What I'll do is I'll click on this extract, and then the complete data, what I'm actually working, will be imported to my data, that is desktop. Now there is no connection between the live data and the data what I see here. So this extract, what it will do, the complete data, whatever is there, it will put it in my desktop, and I can start working offline. This is offline. This is online. When I'm working on this offline, I can work on same kind of data visualizations, everything I can create, provided you should actually use the same column names. You should not change anything here. Once I go back to office, again, if you just say live, it will connect to the live data, whatever is there, and then you'll get the updated reports if any data is updated. So live is online, extract is offline. If you're directly connected, it will be on live. If you are actually going offline, then you can take this extract and then you can start working similarly how you're working on live. Live is little slow because it is pulling the data from the real data source. Extract will actually have the data in your database, in the desktop, and it will be much more faster. Okay, this is live and extract. Next, coming to this data. So one of our friends was asking whether the data should be in a proper manner. Yes, the data should be arranged exactly like a database like this. Then only I can connect it, get the data, and start working on the reports. Why? Because always the data is taken from here. If you have something data here, just try to delete the rows and columns so that you will have the data from here. Now you might say, I have data, the data which is starting from here or somewhere here, it is very difficult for me to clean that. It is very difficult for me to remove all these columns and do it. I'll tell you, if you are importing like that, just thinking that it will become very difficult for me, then you will screw up all the results in Tableau. So it is better to work on the database, clean the database, spend some time on understanding the database, and then start importing, because if your data is clean, aligned properly, it's in a proper order, creating the reports is nothing. It is just drag, drop. That's all. So I always request you guys, make sure that the data, the database, the data types, everything is clean, so that you don't have to bother about creating your reports easily. If you are ignoring this in the beginning, 100% you will be facing a lot of problems while creating your reports. Okay, so please try to understand, clean the data, understand the data, and then connect it, and then start creating the reports. This is very, very important point. Right? Okay. Next, once we import the data, I dragged one table and I dragged in this workspace. Once I do that, I'll get all the data along with that column names. And if you go and check the see, all the columns will be available here. Can I see the data? You can go here. Can you see that? Any of this? See here. I have one small icon here. This one. This says view data. Click on this. I'll get the complete data which I have imported. See? Can I copy this? Yes. You can copy this. Control A. Copy. And you can paste it anywhere you want. Say Excel if you want. See? Paste it. Oops. It's still copying. Copied. The complete data, whatever is there, it got copied. Go back. Close this. Yes. For any of this table, I can go here, click on this, I'll get the database. Now here I can see the data of this table which I've dragged here. And here I can see two icons. It says preview data source, that is the data what we have connected with. And here it says manage metadata. Let me click on this. When I click on this, see, I'm getting only columns. No data is available. Let me click on this again. See, again, I got the data source. Let me click on this. Say, if you go and move your cursor here, it says manage metadata. What is metadata? Metadata is nothing but the information, the details of every columns. What information we'll have? Let's understand. See, I have the column name and here I have the remote name. Why there are two names? See, I have this column name, I have this remote name. Remote name is the source column name from where we have imported, from where we have connected that name. This name is something where I have the flexibility of changing it. Let's go here, double click. See, row ID, I'll make it as RID. Customer name, it's very big. I'll double click, I'll say cust name. See, you cannot change this name. The reason is this is the name which is there from my source. This will help me in creating the reports, but this is just like a visualization, that is in the front end what I'll be showing as a say names. What other informations we have? Table, can you see that? It is a table, it is coming from order table. That is what I have here. Let me drag this people and I'll put it here. Now if you go and check this, let me just go here. It's not showing, to refresh it because it's not connected properly. Let me just remove this. I think there is some refresh problem in my system, but let me just drag this. Sorry about this, it's not getting refreshed here. So what will happen, see, when I go here, so I'll get this table. So if I drag this, I'll get that table as well. Okay, it will show me the table name. So here I change this to row ID, and here it is still says row ID. I change this to RID. Okay, fine. Then I have this table name. Then what other information I'll have? Can you see this? I have some symbols here. This is the main thing what you should understand now. What is this? I'll show you. This, what you see, all these icons represents what kind of data is available in that particular column. That means these are called as data types. Data type is nothing but, let me just click on this. See, I have date here. That means it's a date data type. Here I'll have numbers. Can you see this? These are the numbers. This is number data type. Next. Here, these are the text data type. Okay. So these icons, what you see here, this is for data types. It will make me recognize what kind of data type it is. How to recognize? I'll tell you. If it is ABC, that means it is text. If it is hash here, that means it is number. If it is a kind of calendar, that means it is date data type. If I see here this globe kind of thing, that means it is a geographical data type which will be used for creating maps. Let me click on this. Just click on this. See, I'll get all the different data types. Why this option is coming? I can change these data types. Suppose if you want to change this to string, click on this. This will become string. That means it is text. The technical word which we use for text is string. See, this will become string. See, this is a string actually now. Now let me go and click on this. But guys, I'm telling you, make sure that you just don't change the data type as you wish, because when I'm doing the calculation, if it is not a number, then it'll have a lot of problems. So, okay, say if I go and change this to string, and if this is getting changed to string, so what will happen? This value, the number, whatever is there, this will not do any calculations. Okay, so make sure that while changing the data type, you should be very careful. Right. Now, I have changed this RID. I don't want this RID. I want to have the default value. Click on this small arrow and say, where is that? Refresh. Just. I think there is some problem with my system here. See. I think it's, I'll just remove this and again I'll put it. So guys, there is some refresh problem here. I'll just explain. See, this one will get reset names here. We'll get something called as reset. See here, I've changed, actually it's still showing. Just change this. Here only, see, I'll get this reset name here. I don't know why it is not changing. So if you change here, it will get changed here as well. So if you go here, I'll get this reset name. Click on this. See, again, I'll get back this row ID. Okay, this is called as metadata. I'll explain again. Metadata is nothing but the information about these columns, not the data, about the columns. Right? So I have all the columns here. This is the column name. This is the remote field name. And this is the table. And these are the data types. Let's go back again. Now, what we saw now was for the columns. Now, suppose if I'm studying the data, I want to know, I want to sort these columns. I have this data source order. Click here. I'll say A to Z. When I click on this A to Z, see, it'll get sorted. That is, the columns will get sorted. Z to A, that is descending order. See, ascending and descending. Next, A to Z per table. Suppose if you have more than one table, see, I have the table here. Now, if I select this one, it will sort irrespective of any table. But if I select this A to Z or Z to A, it will sort according to the table. First one table, it will sort, and then the next table. See, it is the next table like this. This option, what you see, the drop down, this is for sorting your columns. Fine. Next, coming to this. Alias name and show hidden fields. I'll come to this show alias later because this is related to the data. Now this one we'll see related to the columns. Let's say I don't want to see this customer ID. Right click and I'll say hide. See, it's getting hidden. Order ID, right click, I'll say hide. Then I'll say discount, I'll hide. I've hidden three columns. Let me remove this. I've hidden three columns. Now I want to know what are the columns I've hidden. So what I'll do, I'll go here. I'll just click on this, show hidden fields, click here. See, it is grayed out. Can you see that? The discount, customer ID, and order ID, which I actually hidden, it is grayed out. So what will happen if it is grayed out or it is hidden? Let me go to this sheet where I have all the columns. See here, customer ID is grayed. I cannot drag and create the reports. But see, I'll just take one of this, a category, and I'll put it here. I can drag it. But I cannot drag this customer ID. I cannot drag this order ID. See, discount, I cannot drag. That means these are hidden and they are not able to use in my worksheet. I can hide from here also. So this part will not do today. So I'm just showing you how this hidden will work. So we'll concentrate only on this part today. Tomorrow I'll explain all this so that you'll not get confused with this part and the reporting part. Okay. So this is for hiding. Suppose if you want to see which all columns are hidden, I can go here and I can check. Otherwise, disable this. See, I'll not be able to see here also in the sheet. If I hidden here, I cannot see. Why this is used? What will happen is when I get the data from a source, let's say I have 100 columns, complete 100 columns I've imported. Then suppose if you want only 10 columns to create the reports, rest 90 columns I don't need. One is I can delete the data in the source itself and then import, or if you've already imported, I can hide all the columns which are not required and then I can start creating the reports. Okay, this is for the column part. Now let's come to the data part. Here I have the data. Now I want to sort this data. Just move your cursor like this. See, I'll get one icon here, like a three dots or three lines. Click here. See, this is ascending. Let's go to this customer. It will be easy for me to understand. See, ascending, descending. You can see that. And click here, remove sort. Ascending, you can see that three lines like this. Descending, and click on this. This is removing the sort. This for sorting the data. This is for sorting the columns. This for sorting the data. Next, let's say, oh yeah, yeah, I have this region. I have some four regions. What I'll do, I will go here and I'll say alias. What is this alias? I'll tell you. Alias is nothing but the alternative name for that particular data. Now let's say I don't want this to be central, east, south, or west. I want this to be CT, ET, ST, and WT. Whichever has got this alias name, whichever I've changed the name, I'll get a star mark here. That means it indicates I have used, say, alias name for this. Say okay. Now if you go here, see, all the values are changed. I'll remove this. See, I'll get the original name. Suppose if any alias is there, just click on this. See, click it, connect. Let's go back to this. And I'll say alias, I'll say clear, and say okay. See, everything is clear. Now even if you select this or not select this, you will not have anything. So alias, if I'm changing this, say go here, let me change this again, say CT, and here I'll say ST. See, only these two are changed. I'll say okay. Now go to this report. Let me take this region and put it here. See, CT and ST. It will not give me the original name in the reports. Okay, this for the alias. Next, you have here the number of rows. It shows 1000, but if you go and check here in this data, I have a 9994 rows. Let's come back. Here it is taking the first 1000 records. I want to see all the data. So what I'll do, just type some maximum number and say enter. See, it'll give me the complete records here. So what it'll do, it'll go and it'll show me first few records. Suppose if you want the complete records to be shown, then type some maximum value. So you don't have to, you know, type the exact value, just type the maximum value, whatever is there, and say enter. What it will do, it will check the complete data, and whatever maximum data is there, it will just display there. Okay, so this is actually the first part what you should know about how to connect, how to study the data, how to study the columns, how to study the data source, and how to be prepared for next level of your Tableau. Okay, so I'll stop here and we can have some discussions.